Hello once again. Today, let's try to find out what's wrong with my motherboard and try to find solutions to fix it. That is, if there's anything we can do about it. Short background on this motherboard. I had this motherboard for like 7 years. When I upgraded my rig, I sold all of the parts except for this motherboard. I tried selling it before, but the buyer returned the item and told me it won't post, and it's been laying around for some time now. I haven't really tried finding out what is really wrong with it since I don't have the parts needed anymore to test it. So I thought about building a budget gaming PC out of it for my next content. So let's find out together and see what we can do about it. This motherboard supports 6th and 7th gen LGA 1151 Intel Core processors, so I bought a used i7-7700 processor cheap for like $50. For the memory, it supports up to 2400 DDR4 RAM up to 64GB system memory. I bought two 16GB 2400 memory modules to make it 32GB total. Let's try one module only for this test. For my power supply unit, I bought a used Silverstone 700 watts PSU for only $15. I am keeping my budget tight for this cheap gaming build. And so far, only the two RAM modules are the brand new parts I bought for around $40. Let's connect the power supply cables to our motherboard, both 24-pin and 8-pin. I don't plan to use this stock Intel CPU cooler for my build, and we'll be getting a much bigger one. But for now, let's use this stock cooler. So let's do this. Crossing fingers it will post. To turn on a motherboard without a power switch, simply short the power switch pin with a screwdriver, like what I'm doing now. It's turning on. Oops, the CPU cooler fan cable is getting in the way. Let's fix it. There you go. Let's wait. It might take a while before it posts. Looks like nothing. The motherboard looks okay though. No unusual error code from the LED lights. There are a bunch of ways to fix a motherboard not displaying anything. First, let's try replacing the CMOS battery and clearing CMOS at the same time. After removing the battery, wait for a few seconds or so to clear the CMOS before placing the new battery. Now let's place the new CMOS battery and try again. I will speed up the playback to not bore you waiting for post to display. It took me around a minute or so waiting for the post, but still nothing. Next, let's try transferring the memory to a different slot. It could have been a bad RAM slot, or it may not be properly seated. I don't think it's a bad memory module because these are brand new modules, and I really hope so that I didn't get a defective RAM module, because it's too much trouble returning and replacing these modules. And let's try again. Still nothing. At this point, I'm trying the third slot. And still nothing. It's pointless now to try the fourth slot. I don't want to use a board with only one RAM slot working. So what else can be the problem? Could it be the display output port? I'm ruling out the cables because I've been using these cables and I'm pretty sure they are all good cables. At this point, I tried the HDMI cable and still no display. But when I tried the VGA port, it works. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to record the video on the VGA cable. But since I'm planning to use a GPU card for my setup, I tried borrowing a GPU card from one of my PC, then attached the DVI cable. And lo and behold, it also works. So it might be something bad along the digital output channel of this board, or the HDMI and DVI port gone bad, and might be also somewhere in the BIOS setup. But most importantly is that this motherboard is fine and good to be used for my next build of budget gaming PC. Please stay tuned for that content in a few days. I'm still on the hunt for some cheap but good GPU to go with this build, and waiting for some parts to arrive. I hope you learned something today about troubleshooting motherboard with no display problem. Until next time, thanks and have a great day.